Do you know the last year was the second hottest year in human history? Currently, surface temperature is rising by about 0.2 degrees Celsius per decade. This is about the stuff. Yes, I am talking about climate change. According to climate scientists, this is mainly due to excessive CO2 emission. On the other hand, most of the usable energy is derived from fossil based fuel, which are being depleted rapidly. Additionally, the fossil fuel are mainly responsible for excessive CO2 emission. Therefore, we are having two vital issues, energy crisis and climate change. Calm down. These two problems can be addressed by a single solution. Now, hydrogen is a fuel coming into the picture. Hydrogen is sustainable because it can be produced from several renewable resources and it has highest energy density as compared to others. The beauty of hydrogen is that it produces only clean water while it is burned. Surprisingly, hydrogen can be produced by biological process. It has some advantages over conventional hydrogen production method. Biohydrogen process are less energy intensive, eco-friendly, and it can utilize waste material as a feedstock at ambient condition. Among all the biological process, dark fermentation has gained a considerable attention by scientists because it is scalable, efficient for waste utilization and low energy demand. A simple mechanism is involved here. Organic waste converted to molecular hydrogen with the help of our little friend bacteria. Amazing, isn't it? As India is the second most populated country in the world, tremendous waste generation is another big issue in our country. Therefore, several industrial, municipal and agricultural waste has been investigated for hydrogen production. In the present research, 1 kg of organic waste produces 125 liter of hydrogen. However, two challenges we have with this dark fermentation process. One is low energy recovery. Maximum, theoretically, 34% energy can be recovered from the waste use. What about the remaining? It goes with the effluent. The second challenge is the direct disposal of the effluent. Now, the question is, producing green energy and disposing the effluent to the environment, is it really green? Obviously, it's big no. In this regard, microalgae cultivation has been coupled with a dark fermentation. Why microalgae? Because microalgae can utilize this effluent for oil accumulation in their cell, which is further used for biodiesel production. Besides, microalgae are photosynthetic organism which produces oxygen consuming carbon dioxide. Again, the second stage process is totally a carbon neutral process because produced CO2 from the vehicle is utilized for algal growth. Consequently, overall energy recovery enhanced significantly up to 80% without hampering the environment. The study was an attempt to develop a sustainable technology for the dual purpose of green energy generation and wastewater treatment. A successful experimental results indicate the scalability of the integrated process which could be dedicated to society. Thank you.